Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operation Research. This is lecture number 2.2 in Transportation Model. The topic for discussion, Transportation Model, Basic Feasible Solution, Optimum Solution and Problems Solving in the Transportation Model. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the two methods of the basic feasible solution. One is least cost method and another one is northwest corner method. So, the third method we are going to discuss and we will take a problem in transportation problem. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to solve problem in transportation model. So, the third method to find the basic feasible solution is Werger's approximation method, so popularly known as VAM. So, we take up one numerical example to understand the VAM. So, find the basic feasible solution for the transportation problem given here using the Werger's approximation method. And there are four destinations and three source points. The capacity of the source points are 200, 400 and 350 and the demand of the destinations are 160, 180, 310 and 300 respectively, and the cost matrix is given. The unit cost of transport from one source to the another destination is given in the matrix. So, here the table is, the matrix is repeated again. The first step, subtract the lowest cell value from the next to lowest cell value and write behind the supply and demand, bottom of the demand. So, you take the first row, first source point, this cost matrix values are 10, 8, 11, 7. The lowest value is 7, the next lowest value is 8, the difference is 1. So, the 1 is written here on the side of the supply. Similarly, second row, the values are 9, 12, 14, 6. The minimum value is 6 and the maximum value is 9. Next minimum value is 9. So, the difference is 3. So, 3 is written here. You take the third row. So, in the third row, 8, 9, 12, 10. They are the cost values, cost matrix values. The minimum value, lowest value is 8. The next lowest value is 9. So, the difference is 1. So, 1 is written here. Now, we take up the column. So, for the column, the cost matrix are 10, 9 and 8. The minimum value, lowest value is 8, next lowest value is 9. The difference is 1. So, the 1 is written here. Second column, 8, 12, 9. So, the minimum value, lowest value is 8, next value is 9. So, the difference is 1. So, the 1 is written here. Then here in the third column, 11, 14, 12. The lowest value is 11, the next lowest value is 12, then the difference is 1, it is written here. Then fourth column, 7, 6 and 10. So, lowest value is 6, the next lowest value is 7, the difference is 1, it is written here. So, for each row and each column, you find the difference between the lowest and the next lowest value and write the values in the supply, behind supply and bottom of the demand. Now, among the lowest value, the highest value is 3. So, highest value is 3. So, the highest difference is 3 corresponding to the second row, exhaust all the supply. So, here the supply point capacity is 400, we have to exhaust all the supply. So, here you take the row, entire row, the lowest value, the lowest cost value is 6. So, here the demand is 300 and the supply capacity is 400, all the demands are satisfied. So, 300 is completely satisfied and the demand of D4 is exhausted. Then, remaining is 100. The 100 is next lowest cell value is 9. So, the 100 is given here in the second cell, first cell, and here the demand is 160. The 100 satisfied here, the balance is 60. So, once you exhausting the source capacity, you have to remove the row. So, we assume that the row is removed and the remaining portion of the table is repeated. So, remove the row and prepare the next table and repeat the procedure. So, the next table is 3. So, now the So the fourth source point, because the demand is satisfied, so that is completely removed, and the source point is satisfied, that is also completely removed. So the balance is the destination 1, 2, 3 and the source point row 1 and 3. Now once again you find the difference. Lowest value here, you take the first row, lowest value is 8, next lowest value is 10, the difference is 2 here. Here 8 and 9, the next value is, difference is 1, and vertically 8, 10, 10, 8, the difference is 2, 8, 9, the difference is 1, 11, 12, the difference is 1, there is no change. Now there are the highest value of the differences, 2 is the highest value, there are 2, 2 value, I take this value. So the column value, now the demand here is 60 and the lowest value is 8, lowest sell value is 8 and the corresponding supply is 350. So all the demand is satisfied here. So X31 equal to 60 and out of 350, now the balance is 290. Now this column is removed, the column 1 is removed and the balance table is written here. Now in this matrix, we have row 1 and 3 and column 2 and 3. Now once again you find the difference, 8, 11, the difference is 3, 9, 12, the difference is 3 and vertically there is no change, 8, 9, 1 and 11, 12, 1. Now the highest difference is 3, now we take this 3, first 3, S1, 3. Now here the capacity is 200 and the lowest sell value is 8, where the demand is 180. So the demand is completely satisfied. So 180, X12 is set to 180 and this column is removed. Now after removing this column, the balance is this one. So we have the third column and the first and the third row. And here the value, now there are only two cells left out. So here we have S1 equal to 20 and the 20 is set to X13 is set to 20 and the remaining here out of 310, the balance is 290. The 290 is satisfied, supplied here. X33 is set to 290. So the demand is completely satisfied. All the supply points, supply values are exhausted. Now the complete table is represented here. The table with the blue color number, this is the allotted cells. So C12, X12 equal to 180, X13 equal to 20, X21 equal to 100, X24 equal to 300. X31 equal to 60 and X33 equal to 290. So the cost, the total cost we have to calculate, the total cost, overall transportation cost, C12 into X12 plus C13 into X13 plus C21 plus X21 plus C24 into X24 plus C31 into X31 plus C33 into X33. Substituting the numerical values, 8 into 180 plus 11 into 20 plus 9 into 100 plus 6 into 300 plus 8 into 60 plus 12 into 290, the cost is rupees 8,320. So this is the Werger's approximation method. Now we compare. So there are three methods to find out the basic feasible solution. Now you compare the three method using a numerical example. So using the northwest corner method, least cost method and the Werger's approximation method. So we calculate the overall transportation cost for a problem and we will understand which is the best among the three methods of finding the basic feasible solution. So this is the example number 2.4. So we have three destination and the four source points. So the three destination demand are 7, 9 and 18. The source point capacities are 5, 8, 7 and 14. So we have to find the basic feasible solution using the three method. So first we take the northwest corner method. So before we solve the problem, we have to check whether this is balanced type of problem. We have to find the total demand requirement and the total supply capacity. So the total demand requirement is 34 and the supply capacity is 34. So it is a balanced type of problem and we can proceed with the solution method. So the first method is northwest corner method. So here we have to start from the cell X11. So here X11, we have to check the demand. Demand is 7 and the supply capacity is 5. So we have to exhaust all the supply here. So supply X11, set X11 equal to 5 and proceed. So the supply capacity is completely exhausted. We move vertically downward. So there is the cell X21. Now for this cell, the demand is 2. So the 7 is reduced to 2 and the supply capacity is 8. So we satisfy all the demand, and the demand is completely satisfied, and the supply capacity S2 is reduced to 6. Now we move horizontally. So horizontal to the row, to the cell X22. So for this cell, the supply capacity is 6 and the demand equal to 9. So now all the supply capacity S2 is exhausted. So here X22 is set to 6 and the demand is reduced to 3 now. Now we have to move vertically downward. So to the cell X32, and in this cell now the demand is 3 and whereas supply capacity S3 equal to 7. Now you set X32 equal to 3. So the demand is completely satisfied and the supply capacity is reduced to 4. Now you move horizontally to the cell X33. Now here the supply capacity is 4 and the demand is 18. So the 4 is completely supplied here. So the S3 is exhausted. So X33 is set to 4 and the demand is reduced to 14. Now we move vertically downward to the last cell. So where X43, the demand is 14 and supply capacity is 14. So X43 is set to 14. So starting from the left top corner and reaching the right bottom corner is the northwest corner method, and the overall transportation cost is C11 X11 plus C21 X21 plus C22 X22 plus C32 X32 plus C33 X33 plus C43 X43. Calculating, substituting numerical values, 2 into 5 plus 3 into 2 plus 3 into 6 plus 4 into 3 plus 7 into 4 plus 2 into 14 equal to ₹102. So next we take the least cost method. So the table, the matrix is completely, it is given here again. And in the least cost method, first we have to find out the lowest cell value, lowest cost matrix. So in the cost matrix, lowest cell value C41 equal to 1 and C23 equal to 1. These are all the two lowest value. First we make the assignment here. So here cell number X41, the demand is 7 and the supply capacity is 14. So we satisfy all the demand here. So it is set to X41 is set to 7 and the balance of the supply capacity is 7. The next value again 1 we have. So here we make the second assignment where the demand is 18, supply capacity is 8. So we exhaust all the supply capacity, X23 equal to 8, and the supply capacity is exhausted, and here the balance equal to 10. The third value is 2, the minimum cost equal to 2. Now we exhaust, we supply here. Here the demand is 10, whereas the availability is only 7. Available is only 7. Supply capacity is 7. We exhaust all the supply capacity. We set the X43 equal to 7 and the balance is only 3. Then next lowest cost is 4. So we make 4 here. C32 is equal to 4. X32 equal to 7. So the demand here, supply capacity is 7 and the demand equal to 9. So we exhaust all the supply capacity. So we set the X32 equal to 7 and the balance demand equal to 2. The next value is 5. So here we make the assignment where the cost equal to 4. So the here for this cell, the demand is 3, whereas the supply capacity is 5. We set the X13 equal to 3 and this demand D3 is completely satisfied and S1 is reduced to 2. The next value is 7. The cost value is 7, where we have X12 equal to, set X12 equal to 1 because the demand equal to 2 and the supply capacity equal to 2. So we set X12 equal to 2. So these are all the 6 assignments. All the supplies are exhausted. All the demands were satisfied. Now the overall transportation cost. So we calculate the overall transportation cost. C12 into X12 plus C13 into X13 plus C23 into X23 plus X32 into C32 into X32 plus C41 into X41 plus C43 into X43. So calculating 7 into 2 plus 4 into 3 plus 1 into 8 plus 4 into 7 plus 1 into 7 plus 2 into 7 equal to ₹83. So next we take the Weigel's approximation method. And in the Weigel's approximation method, first we have to find the difference in the cost matrix. Row wise and the column wise, you have to find the difference. So we take the first row, the lowest cost is 2, the next lowest cost is 4, the difference is 2 here. And the second row, lowest cost is 1 and the next value is 3, the difference is 2 again. And in the third row, the lowest value is 4 and next lowest value is 5, the difference is 1. And in the fourth row, lowest value is 1, the next lowest value is 2, the difference is 1. Now we take the column, vertical column. So lowest value in the first column is 1 and the next lowest value is 2, the difference is 1. And the second column, the lowest value is 3 and next value is 4, the difference is 1. And the third column, the lowest value is 1, the next value is 2, the difference is 1 again. So among the lowest values, the highest value is 2. We take the first assignment here. We take the first assignment in this row. So the supply capacity is S1 equal to 5. We have to exhaust all the supply capacity. Among the three values in the row, the lowest value, cost value is C11 equal to 2. Here the demand is 7 and the supply capacity is 5. So the supply is completely exhausted. So we set X11 equal to 5. And here the balance equal to 2. The next highest value is 2. Again, this is the second assignment. So here the supply capacity is 8. So we take, considering the second row, the lowest cell value is 1. So here the demand is 18 and the supply capacity is 8. So all the supply are exhausted here. So we set X23 equal to 8 and the balance here, balance on the demand equal to 10. Now these two rows are deleted. Now we find the difference. There is no change in the row value, but there is a change in the column value. So you have to look at the value 1, 5, which is 4, 4, 6, 2, and 7, 2, which is 5. The next highest value is 5. So we make the third assignment here in this column. Now in this column, the demand available, demand requirement is 10, whereas the so the first two rows are removed now. So we have only two rows. So here the lowest cell value is 2. So here the supply capacity is 14, whereas demand equal to 10. We satisfy all the supply capacity. We set the demand requirement. We set the X43 equal to 10. So among 14, 10 is removed, the balance equal to 4. Now this column is again removed. The next highest difference is this 5. So we make the fourth assignment is here. Now we have only the 4 cells. So these 4 cells are available here. Now the lowest in this row, the lowest value is C4 equal to 1, where the demand equal to 2. So we set the X41 equal to 2. Now out of 4, the remaining is 2. Now the next cell value is C42 equal to 6, where the demand equal to 9. So we have only 2 supply capacity. So 2 is set here, the balance equal to 7. Now the remaining only cell available here is this C32 equal to 4, where the demand is 7 and the supply capacity is 7. We set the X32 equal to 7. So the cells with the rose color, they are the allotted cells, and we calculate the cost of the transportation cost using the Weigel's approximation method. So this is the final assignment with the 5. So here we make the assignment. Now the overall transportation cost C11 X11 plus C23 X23 plus C32 X32 plus C41 X41 plus C42 X42 plus C43 X43. Substitute numerical values 2 into 5 plus 1 into 8 plus 4 into 7 plus 1 into 2 plus 6 into 2 plus 2 into 10 equal to rupees 80. Now we calculated the transportation cost using the 3 method and we compare. So using the northwest corner method, the solution is 102 rupees 102. For the least cost method, it is 83, and the Weigel's approximation method, it is 80. So among the 3 method, so the Weigel's approximation method, it gives the minimum cost. So in the next optimization problem, first we have to start with the Weigel's approximation method. So even we can start with the northwest corner method, but the number of iterations for getting optimum solution will be more. So when you use the Weigel's approximation method, the number of iterations required to reach the optimum cost is will be less. That is why we start with the lowest cost. So the lowest cost is given by the Weigel's approximation method, so that we can easily solve the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written mechanical engineering subject. You may find the operation research book. You can refer to the book for additional information on the transportation model. I upload the video lectures of the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel, use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments in the comments box. You can contact me for any help in the subject. So we'll continue with the transportation problem in the next lecture for optimizing the solution. So we take up the finding the method of finding the optimum solution in the next video lecture. Until then, bye bye.